We are ready for the release pipeline. So click on Pipelines and click on Releases. Let's create a new release. Click on New and New Release Pipeline. Since my application is hosted on IIS machine, so select a IIS template. You can see many templates for IIS deployment. I am going with IIS website deployment. Select and apply. Give the stage name. Stage name can be anything, like download the source code from version control system. Go ahead and close it. Now click on add an artifact. We need to select a artifact location or artifact to be deployed. We are going to use a artifact from build process. You can select a artifact type from any of them. You can also use a Jenkins as a source code. Select a project. I am selecting a project ESOP and source build pipeline. Select a build pipeline. So my pipeline is ESOP-CI default version. I am okay with the latest. You can use any of the conditions. Source alias, set a default and click on add. Once artifact step is ready, click on jobs and task. These are default tasks in a template. The first task is useful when you are creating a new application or website. Since my website is already created, hence I am deleting this step. Right click and remove selected task. We are going to use this task to deploy the code on IIS machine. Give any display name. I am okay with that. Give the website name on which you want to deploy your code. By default it's selected default website, but we are going to deploy our code on ESOP application. Take the name of the website and go to deploy package on IIS machine and give the website name here. Now go back in steps. Now you can see website name got changed from default website to ESOP website. We are not using the virtual application, so leave it. Package and folder for the artifact. So we are going to use a artifact from build process, so leave it by default. You can use the advanced options like file transformation or variable. I am not explaining these options right away, but these options are very useful when you are going to replace a variable in a file according the environment. I am creating a separate video where I am replacing the connection string in a web.config file according the environment. I am going to select one option in advanced deployment, and this is take application offline. It means that your application will be offline during the code deployment. It is very useful features when you want to take a offline your application while deploying the code. I am okay with the default setting in control options and output variables. I would like to add one more step. In this stage, take a backup of the application content by using the PowerShell. It is not a good policy to maintain a backup deployment, but many organizations recommended to keep a copy of the content of last deployment. For this activity, we are going to use a PowerShell template. So click on plus sign and search a PowerShell template. Here you go. Run a PowerShell script on Linux, Mac or Windows. Click on add. A task successfully added. Let's bring this task on the top. Give the display name. I am okay with the default one. And select a inline type. Use this PowerShell script to take a backup and keep a copy of the last deployment. It is going to take a backup from this location and copy on this location. It maintains a single copy of last deployment. No other settings required on this task. We required only to create this location on each server. so that the PowerShell script can create a backup for the content. You need create this path on each machine. Backup path has been created on all three machines. If you notice that, you will see a warning message, some settings need attentions. On IIS deployment, click on it. You require to select a deployment group. We created this particular group for the development, so click on Dev. You can select a deployment on multiple machine or one machine at a time. It is a good practice, use the second option, one target at a time. You can define the timeout value or job cancel timeout value. Select a default artifact or build pipeline. In my case is ESOP-CI. I am okay with other default option. I am not creating any custom variables. I am okay with the default retention policy. I am not selecting any other options. Now click on pipeline. This particular stage created for the dev environment, we need to create another two stage, one for QA and one for production environment. Instead of creating a stage for QA environment from the scratch, you can clone this stage for the QA environment. Click on clone and click on newly created stage. You can give the stage name. I am giving the QA stage 1 and close it. Let's verify the jobs and tasks. I am okay with these options. Click on IIS deployment. Select the deployment group from dev to QA. Go to PowerShell script. We are okay with all options. And click on second task. We are okay all options. Click on pipelines. Now another QA stage has been created. Now click on pre-deployment conditions and select the trigger. I am going to use the option called after stage. I want to start QA stage after completing dev stage automatically. Select the dev stage. You can leave all other option default. Go ahead and close it. So now this QA stage are going to automatically start after completing dev stage. Let's create a last stage for the production environment. Let's clone it for the production environment. Click on it. Change the stage name. And click on jobs and task. We are okay on this step. Change deployment group from QA to prod. We are okay with the rest of the options. Verify the PowerShell. We don't require to modify anything. Let's verify IIS web deployment part. We don't require to change any other settings. Click on pipelines. Now we are going to add a approval process between QA and production. The production stage should not start automatically after completing QA stage. It should be start after having a proper approvals. So click on pre-deployment condition, select trigger after stage QA and enable the option pre-deployment approvals. Select a group of users or user for the approvals. For the demonstration, I am assigning myself as a approver. Give the timeout parameters. This setting reject automatically release pipeline after define timeout value. For example, if this pipeline doesn't approve within the 12 hours, it is going to be reject automatically. I am okay at the default options. Change the release pipeline name. Go ahead and save it. Now we are ready with all three steps. Build pipeline. Deployment groups. Machines are up and online on each deployment groups. And finally, release pipeline is created. Let's start end-to-end deployment. So first we are going to build a artifact or package from the source code. So click on pipelines, then click on builds, then select build pipeline and click on queue. Select the agent pool Azure Pipelines, select the agent 2017 and select the master branch. Leave the default options and run it. Your build process started. Build pipeline has been completed and it generated application artifacts. You can download the application artifacts from here, or it is available to release on the IIS machine. In the second step, we are going to deploy application artifact on IIS machine by using release pipeline. So click on release and select the stage 1 deploy package on IIS machine. Select the latest artifacts. Give the release description. Go ahead and create it. On the top you can see here release 1 has been created. Click on it. Since deployment on development machine is manual, hence we need to start deployment on development machine manually. Click on deploy. Go ahead and deploy. You can watch the logs, code deployment in the progress. These are tasks. It has been completed. Now QA stage is in progress. We can see logs. It also completed. Now you can see here production stage is waiting for the approval. Before approve the production stage, we need to verify the application on dev and QA and make sure that this application is working fine on dev and QA. This is my development machine. Release pipeline created application backup on this location in the first task. In second task, it deployed the application code on the website. You can see here. Let's try to access the application on the browser. Okay, application is working fine on the browser for the development machine. Let's verify the QA environment. This is my QA environment. It created a backup copy of application deployment. It also deployed the application code in the website. Let's try to access QA application on the browser. QA environment also working fine. In real time enterprise environment, we will perform all kind of the testing along with the smoke test or load testing on dev and QA environment before approve on the production environment. Since our application is working fine on dev and QA environment, let's approve for the production environment. I am going to approve in the release pipeline. Give any kind of the comments. Go ahead and approve it. Now you can see here production stage is in progress. You can check logs anytime. It has been completed. Let's verify on the server side. It created a backup copy of the application deployment. It also deployed the code on the website. Let's verify the website on the browser. Okay. Application also working fine on the production environment. So these are complete steps to deploy your application on dev to production with the approvals. That's it in this video. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.